dear students. I am Diana Hermosilla, your teacher in grade 9 mathematics. Today's lesson is about the sum and the product of the roots of quadratic equation. Here you will learn interesting and useful relations between the coefficients and roots of quadratic equation. Here are the objectives of our lesson. Number 1, determine the sum and the product of the roots of quadratic equation using the values of a, b, and c. And number 2, write the quadratic equation whose roots are given.
If the quadratic equation is written in a standard form, ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we can find the sum and product of roots by the coefficient of the quadratic term, coefficient of the linear term, and the constant term, or simply the values of a, b, and c. Remember that the roots of the quadratic equation can be determined by the quadratic formula x is equal to negative b plus and minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. From this, we can derive the formula of the sum and product of the roots of quadratic equation. Let x sub 1 and x sub 2 be the roots of the quadratic equation. X sub 1 is equal to negative b plus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, and x sub 2 is equal to negative b minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Let us now derive the formula of the sum of roots by adding the two roots of quadratic equation. X sub 1 plus x sub 2 is equal to negative b plus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a plus negative b minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. X sub 1 plus x sub 2 is equal to negative b plus negative b is equal to negative 2b, square root of b squared minus 4ac minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac is 0. Copy the denominator 2a. Negative 2b divided by 2a is equal to negative b over a. The sum of the roots of the quadratic equation is negative b over a. Now, we will derive the formula of the product of the roots by multiplying the two roots of quadratic equation. X sub 1 times x sub 2 is equal to quantity negative b plus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a times the quantity negative b minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Negative b times negative b is equal to quantity negative b squared, positive square root of b squared minus 4ac times negative square root of b squared minus 4ac is equal to negative quantity square root of b squared minus 4ac squared. 2a times 2a is equal to quantity 2a squared. Quantity negative b squared is equal to b squared. Negative quantity square root of b squared minus 4ac squared is equal to negative quantity b squared minus 4ac. Quantity 2a squared is equal to 4a squared. By simplifying this expression, we have b squared negative times b squared is equal to negative b squared. Negative times negative 4ac is equal to positive 4ac all over 4a squared. B squared minus b squared is 0. Bring down 4ac. Copy the denominator 4a squared. 4ac divided by 4a squared is equal to c over a. So therefore, the product of the roots of quadratic equation is c over a. We will now determine the sum and product of the roots of quadratic equation using the formulas of the sum and product of the roots. Example number 1. Find the sum and product of the roots of the quadratic equation x squared minus 5x plus c is equal to 0. First, we will identify the values of a, b, and c. In this equation, the value of a is 1, the value of b is negative 5, and the value of c is 6. By substitution, sum of roots is equal to negative b over a, negative, and then the value of b, quantity negative 5, over the value of a, 1, negative times negative 5 is positive 5, divided by 1 is equal to positive 5. Product of the roots is equal to c over a, the value of c is 6, and the value of a is 1, 6 divided by 1 is equal to 6. Example number 2. Find the sum and product of the roots of the quadratic equation 2x squared plus 8x is equal to 10. Notice that the equation is not written in a standard form, so we need to write the equation in a standard form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. 2x squared plus 8x is equal to 10. By addition property, we'll add negative 10 to both sides of the quadratic equation. So 2x squared plus 8x minus 10 is equal to 0. Next is to identify the values of a, b, and c. The value of a is 2, the value of b is 8, and the value of c is negative 10. By substitution, sum of the roots negative b over a is equal to negative value of b 8 over 2. Negative 8 divided by 2 equals negative 4. Product of the roots, c over a, the value of c is negative 10, over the value of a, 2, negative 10 divided by 2 is negative 5. Example number 3. Find the sum and product of the roots of the quadratic equation, x squared minus 7 is equal to 0. First, identify the values of a, b, and c. In this equation, the value of a is 1, the value of b is 0, and c is equal to negative 7. Sum of the roots is equal to negative b over a. By substitution, the negative sign, and then the value of b 0, over the value of a 1, 0 divided by 1 is equal to 0. Product of the roots, c over a is equal to the value of c, negative 7, over the value of a, 1, negative 7 divided by 1 is equal to negative 7. It's easy to find the sum and product of the roots given the quadratic equation, right? How about if the given are the roots? How would you determine the quadratic equation? Remember that if the general quadratic equation is written in the form x squared plus b over ax plus c over ax is equal to 0, then x squared minus quantity sum of root x plus quantity product of the roots is equal to 0. This relationship is useful in writing quadratic equations whose roots are given. For example, write a quadratic equation whose roots are 3 and 2. X sub 1 plus x sub 2 is equal to negative 3 over a. By substitution, 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. X sub 1 times x sub 2 is equal to c over a. 3 times 2 is equal to 6. Substitute in the form x squared minus the sum of the roots times x plus the product of the roots is equal to 0. We have x squared minus the sum of the roots 5 times x, so we have 5x, plus the product of the roots 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, the quadratic equation is x squared minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. Example number 2. Write the quadratic equation whose roots are negative 3 and 5. X sub 1 plus x sub 2 is equal to negative 3 over a. Negative 3 plus 5 is equal to positive 2. X sub 1 times x sub 2 is equal to c over a. Negative 3 times 5 is equal to negative 15. substitute in the form x squared minus the sum of roots x plus product of the roots is equal to 0, we have x squared minus the sum of the roots 2 times x is equal to 2x plus the product of the roots negative 15 is equal to 0. Therefore, the quadratic equation is x squared minus 2x minus 15 is equal to 0. Example number 3. Write a quadratic equation whose roots are negative 7 and negative 3 over 2. X sub 1 plus x sub 2 is equal to negative 3 over a. Addition of the similar fractions. Negative 7 plus negative 3 over 2. 2 divided by 1 is 2 times negative 7 is negative 14. 2 divided by 2 is 1 times negative 3 is negative 3. Negative 14 minus 3 is equal to negative 17. Copy the denominator 2, so we have negative 17 over 2. X sub 1 times x sub 2 is equal to c over a. Negative 7 times negative 3 over 2 is equal to positive 21 over 2. Substitute in the form x squared minus quantity sum of roots x plus quantity product of the roots is equal to 0. We have x squared minus the sum of the roots negative 17 over 2x plus the product of the roots 21 over 2 is equal to 0. Simplifying this equation, we have x squared negative times negative 17 over 2x is positive 17 over 2x plus 21 over 2 is equal to 0. We will simplify this further by multiplying both sides of the equation by 2. 2 times x squared is 2x squared. 2 times 17 over 2x is 17x. 2 times 21 over 2 is equal to 21. So we have 2x squared plus 17x plus 21 is equal to 0. Example number 4. Write the quadratic equation whose roots are 2 plus square root of 15 and 2 minus square root of 15. X sub 1 plus x sub 2 is equal to negative 3 over a. 2 plus square root of 15 plus 2 minus square root of 15. 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Square root of 15 minus square root of 15 is 0. So we have 4. X sub 1 times x sub 2 is equal to c over a. Quantity 2 plus square root of 15 times quantity 2 minus square root of 15. 2 times 2 is 4. Square root of 15 times negative square root of 15 is negative 15. 4 minus 15 is equal to negative 11. Substitute in the form x squared minus sum of roots x plus product of roots is equal to 0. We have x squared minus the sum of roots 4 times x is equal to 4x plus the product of the roots negative 11 is equal to 0. So the quadratic equation is x squared minus 4x minus 11 is equal to 0.
And that concludes our lesson about the sum and product of the roots of quadratic equation. I hope you learned a lot today. You may now start answering the activities provided in your modules. Until next time, good luck and God bless.